it's really about telling stories. It's about unpacking the science, the legislation, the way to do risk assessment, but anchoring it back into one or other of the many real world examples I've been involved in. So this isn't a theoretical abstract summer school. It's about helping give people the skills and the knowledge in a way that will stick, so that when they get back to work on the Monday morning, they've got little hooks that will allow them to draw down from the knowledge we've shared with them, because they've got the stories in their mind. The two key things that people will benefit from on the summer school is an appreciation of the role of the conceptual site model and the way that risk assessment informs decision making. So the conceptual site model is a graph, a map, a cross section, and a diagram that shows how contaminants, pathways, and receptors, things we're trying to protect, are connected. And it also shows what we don't know well enough, so that will inform any further sampling that you want to do. And then risk assessment is about, under a particular legal context, for a particular set of contaminants, working out the risks to human health principally, but also ecosystems, and using that to drive the decision about whether or not you need to remediate. The environmental aspects of what we do is ignored. There's a whole field of statistics which deals with the fact that samples have a location, they have an address, an X and a Y and a depth. And if you throw that away and you just simply look at the measurements, then you're in danger of getting some seriously wrong answers. So spatial statistics, the field of geostatistics, pioneered by a French professor called George Mathurin, and operationalized at Stanford by a guy called André Jonel, is fine. But classical statistics, which doesn't consider the location of your sample, is a recipe to disaster.